Some initiatives of the federal government of Nigeria. On assumption of office as Minister of Labour and Productivity in 2010, I faced a lot of challenges and a lot of problems that were not taken by the government of the day. But because of details of integrated character and well, everybody here will attend within the period of the military change and the period civilians came back to power, a lot of damage has been caused. Crisis are inherited for unemployment from the statistics rather than the direct. By the time we came into the 2011, unemployment crisis has risen to the highest level. Another one was industrial Islamic, and this is what on the day I assumed that we need to talk about. The entire federal civil service was on strike. So the major concern was to get them back to work. And then I did that with the support of the president and the president. The next issue was the issue of standardization of the service sector, issues of assessment, issues of contract status. I promised the Nigerians that I would tackle it. So the major crisis was what do we do to create employment? I think with a national action plan on employment creation for the resident of the topic. Another document is a policy document put together by the Federal Ministry of Labour under my leadership on the assumption of office as the Honourable Minister of Labour and Productivity, which was subsequently approved by the Federal Executive Council in line with the transformation of Nigeria. Government has already demonstrated its overall commitment to the implementation of the action plan. It was for this reason that the Federal Executive Council approved that the National Action Plan on Employment Creation be adopted as the strategic national working topic and incorporated into our national development plan at all levels of government. The implementation of the National Action Plan, National Plan of Action on Employment Creation, would result and has yielded in the creation of massive employment in 12 strategic sectors of the economy with high potential for employment generation. The sectors identified there and as follows, agriculture. Agriculture has created a lot of jobs. The target of Dr. Agni Adeyemi is that in the space of 3 years that he will create 5 million, as at now he has created about 1.5 million jobs. Then the agriculture again, received by the current government of the Council of Jonathan as a means of diversification for the economy. So we are not only using agri as a means of job creation. Agri has come as the diversification process because if you recall, in the first republic, there were pyramids of grammars. Universities, APE, Amandale University, was used to the process from that. All the development in the northern Nigeria was done through agri. In the eastern part of the country, we had a farm on them. And farm on it, before it was taken, Malaysia and Indonesia started the farm. It was the next day of government of the eastern region. So go to the west and proceed from it. So we are going back to what it used to be. And the pyramids are the promise. Farm oil begins to go by the difference from national and government. So I think we are looking at it as a business. And because I mean, I'm particularly interested that the successes already being recognized are being translated into job creation.
To be the guest speaker at our breakfast meeting, thank you very much. Now we look forward to an enhanced relationship between you and our teachers. Thank you very much.
The movie, the movie. Thank you.
It is no wonder that as far back as in 1943, the
Environment has been the most widespread malady of our generation. It is a specific disease of the Western civilization of our time. There is no mistake the fact that all kinds of long term saw in 1943 as a problem of the West has become a global cancer war that has taken the into the fabric of most things, even though. Coming back home this season, I believe it is no longer strange to hear that the higher rate of employment in Nigeria is one of the most difficult problems in developing the country, in spite of the nation's enormous human and material.